Morning lecturers, my name is Kelvin.
I'm Delwin. I'm Rindy.
I'm Atika.
I'm Benson.
I'm Rachel.
And we are from the ABO for Group 2. Today we are here to present to you about Olympus. So what is Tobashi? Tobashi is an app to make losses fly away. In other words, it's a financial fraud with hidden losses. What company that uses Tobashi will be Olympus? So how is Olympus related? Olympus covers a total of 2.3 billion investment loss in 1990. This was executed by the three directors of the company. In the late 1990s, they hide losses in the setup fund for the purpose of loss-making security. Three means were used, engaged in secret scene to buy a European firm, making use of the deposit secured loan from the Singapore Commerce Bank and Venture Capital Fund in Japan. They involved in a complicated complex transfer which makes the fraud uneasily discovered. Now I'll pass on the slides to Delwin.
Of the board making up independent director. Now I'll pass on the time to Atika. of principle 2 of independence is that they disallow any individual or small groups to have dominance over their board, and they encourage objective judgment on corporate affairs independently. So when Michael Woodford discovered about the dubious action of the company, he decided to do his own personal investigation on the matter by bringing external parties into the picture. However, he was found out and he was sacked by the board. And the act of sacking Mr. Michael Woodford is to protect their own people from being found out. And through this, there is no judgment objective practice, and also that the decision made wasn't based on independent viewpoint. Hence, I will be passing over my time to Benson.
Okay, so thank you, Atika. So now I'll be talking about the importance of board independence. So, firstly, is to prevent the conflict of interest. Decision make have no hidden agenda, encourage an enhancement of the company, and they also act as a barrier to prevent individual or group to overpower the entire board. So with independence, the company vision will be less cloudy, so that they are able to make objective judgment and also make proper decision, and also at the same time preventing fraud from happening. So now I'll talk about the lack of board independence in Olympus. Okay, so the first one, the non-independent director overpower the board, which also means that in the board there are very little independent directors. Second, the CEO and the chairman are of the same person. And third, the culture of Olympus, CEO works are supreme, which means everybody in the board or in the company can't go against the CEO words, which means whatever the CEO say, you have to do it. And the last point, individual operate with fear and hardly speak about the wrongdoing to superior, which means that individual, whatever the individual think they are doing wrong, they cannot change it as they fear the superior. So now I'll pass my time to Rachel.
Thank you, Benson. Now I'll be presenting on Olympus external and internal auditors. So for external auditors, they are responsible for commenting on the accounting report weaknesses and also to give advice and recommendations on the firm's accounting policies. The internal auditors, on the other hand, are to report risk and also give recommendations on how to improve the effectiveness and efficiency of the company, and also to ensure that the company complies with the financial reporting standards. Next, we'll move on to Olympus external auditors. So Olympus hired KPMG Asa and also hired Ernst & Young Shin Nihon. However, the question everyone may be asking is, how is it that the external auditors were unable to discover the cover even though they were one of the big four companies? So the answer being that the cover was too cleverly hidden for outsiders to detect. KPMG signed off after Olympus had made an obscure acquisition of a medical equipment in 2009. However, no further investigations have occurred. So therefore, my group's conclusion is that although the external auditors did not participate in the cover-up, they however had knowledge about it and were suspicious of Olympus, but they failed to raise any red flags and did not report any of their suspicion. Next, we'll move on to the internal auditors. So Olympus had took five of their internal auditors to court who were suspected to be involved in the cover-up. Three of them are present auditors and two were passed. The three present were in place before the scandal occurred and failed to sound any alarm. This may be because of Japan's corporate culture where everyone protects their own and have undue loyalty to their superiors. This may cause the internal auditors to help in the cover-up and prevent and did not raise any alarms about the scandal that was happening. Therefore, my group's conclusion is that the internal auditors did participate in the cover-up, although the extent of their participation is undetermined. They turned a blind eye on the cover-up and did not report any suspicion or any fraud. Next, we'll have a skip. Thank you.
The investment loss could be. We cannot report this.
I agree.
We have to cover this up.
Okay, so the previous scene, right, is talking about how the Japanese board of directors are discussing discussing to hide your investment losses. Something's not right. I have to report this. Okay, so whistleblowing involves a person exposing any kind of information deemed illegal or dishonest. So Mr. Woodford is the whistleblower. Thank you.
Too fast, right?
Ha ha ha.